I love this time of year as I feel compelled to look back on the year that has just been and consider what the next year will bring. Back in January last year, I had no idea what new possibilities would develop during the course of the year. For example, I wouldn't have known that I would be in the Houses of Parliament on two occasions with the Commonwealth Parliamentarian Association, or that I would be in Athens with the World Health Organization. If there's one thing that has stood out to me in the work that I've been involved in, it has been how interconnected the key themes are that emerge across the variety of subject matter that I've had the privilege to capture. I've also listened to the local, national and international contexts of conversations on the same subject, so I guess it feels like that 2018's experience of being a visual practitioner has been both broad and deep. I've tried to work out how I can share this with you and come up with two visual aids. For the first one, in this video, I've used a PESTLE analysis to map out the context of the subjects that I've been involved in, using the political, economic, social, technological, legal, environmental indicators to describe this. Thinking about the political context, at the beginning of the year, I was involved in a forum hosted by the Commonwealth Parliamentarian Association for members of Parliament from across the Commonwealth. The themes were fairness, sustainability, security and prosperity. Clearly, this four-day event covered the other contexts of environmental, economic, social and technological impact. The Sustainable Development Goals were key levers to raising issues that were covered. This piece of work gave me the international context for the work that I had been involved in both nationally and locally throughout the year. 2018 has also been the 70th birthday of the NHS. New Possibilities was involved in work that the Kingsfund and Ipsos Mori were undertaking to establish public opinion about the future of the NHS, which of course is hugely political. I was also involved in capturing an event about equality, diversity and public patient participation in health services, again, hugely political. I've already mentioned the Commonwealth Forum and the conversations around the Sustainable Development Goals, and in addition to this, I've worked with NHS Foundation Trusts and CCGs to help them map out their strategic priorities, which will inevitably influence their economic spend over the next few years. Social. This is where the bulk of my work takes place. It's something that I feel passionate about. Capturing, recording, and communicating people's experiences of using services. The subject matter is far-reaching and includes modern-day slavery, perinatal mental health, learning disability, dementia, children and young people experiences, cancer services, maternity experiences, and housing. There are some pieces of work that I was looking forward to seeing how they would grow and develop during the year. I've been working with Jill Phillips, who created the board game Whose Shoes 10 years ago. I've thoroughly enjoyed working with Jill over the years, and we have lots of excellent adventures and witnessed some groundbreaking engagement work that has been a catalyst to bring about grassroots change in the way maternity services are delivered. The use of this game to focus on maternity experiences has grown over the last 4 years. During 2018, I was looking forward to travelling to Ireland to capture the conversations in Galway. I hadn't anticipated that this trip would coincide with the reform vote on abortion. I also hadn't anticipated the enthusiasm and commitment to the Whose Shoes board game across maternity services in Ireland. In addition to this work, a set of cards was launched at the end of 2018 that focuses specifically on perinatal mental health, mind and body, such an incredibly important topic with such a breadth of impact on women, their babies and partners. I know that 2019 will hold lots of opportunities to immerse myself in listening to the conversations and capturing records that reflect the key issues that affect women and their partners, and to be able to identify what is needed to best support women who experience mental ill health during this period of their life. Environmental. There have been two pieces of work that have really tapped into environmental issues that I really care about. One was for the London Borough of Lewisham, about air quality and looking at how it will become part of the ultra-low emission zone and reduce health inequalities of those people living in the most polluted parts of the city. The second was a piece of work in Stoke-on-Trent, who are looking at becoming a sustainable food city, again focusing on the health inequalities for those people who live in low-income areas, with the intention of improving opportunities to have access to healthy food options. Technological. One of the things that I love about my job is the unpredictable nature of knowing where new customers will come from, and I had a number of those during 2018. One that stretched me most was about user experience of using a piece of software that had been developed to track and monitor the movement of shipping vessels around coastal seas. The target group was harbour port officers and lifeguards, an absolutely fascinating and enlightening experience. Legal. In the summer of 2018, I captured an event that focused on the experience of offenders with a learning disability and the impact that the justice system can have on their quality of life. In addition to this, I was involved in the Learning Disability Mortality Review, which highlighted the inequalities in human rights that exist for people with learning disability and the impact that that can have on their lives. Community. This is something that I've added to the PESTLE analysis, and for me sits across both the social and environmental contexts, and is another area of work that has really resonated with me during 2018. Within the current political and economic context, it feels like now more than ever, people need to feel connected to their community, to have a sense of belonging and purpose. I will talk some more about how community development has influenced me in the next video, which is about impact. I hope that this video has given you an insight into how varied the work is that I'm involved in.